Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to build this kind of shape with its intertwined stripes that it has around this circle. So intertwine, of course, is a nice keyword because we could use the intertwine feature in Illustrator to build this, draw kind of a star-like shape and offset the path in order to get this stroke here, and then use intertwine to intertwine that along that border. So the trouble with that approach is you would have to adjust the intertwinement at a lot of places because there are a lot of over, under, around this border. So that is an idea, but it might not be the most efficient one. What else can we do? We can, of course, use a brush, a pattern brush, and then get this kind of thing around the border. The nice thing about a brush is, should you ever need to do this again with a different shape, then you just apply the brush and you're done with it. The only problem is to build that brush. Now, in order to build that brush, of course, we need to think about how to build these three lines around it. And as I said, we might think about offsetting the path, and we can think about, has that been used here? And it's kind of unlikely, because if you offset the path, then you might not get these things here, because you might start with the center line of this and then you need to offset to both sides. And in that case, at the tight corners, you most probably get really corners. So let's just try that out. If I make a star and then let's make this rounded and make a stroke to this, like a fat stroke, like so. And let's have, you know, like this. And when you then make an offset to this, offset path, you know, object path, and then use offset path, then what you get is a corner here, where the rounding is tighter. So most probably this hasn't been created like that. So we need a different method to create that, which is another type of brush. So we're going to start with that brush. So I'm going to use the rectangle tool and make some rectangles. Let's just switch fill and stroke by using Shift X, and then let's duplicate these. Like so, I'm going to zoom in slightly more, and then let's delete this again and get it in one move, and then Command D or Control D on Windows, like so. Okay, so this will be our base brush, and what I'm going to do is use different colors because we need white in this, we need a background, and I'd like to see that. So let's make it just with, I'm going to need slightly more distance between them. So let's use the align feature and then let's have the background. And I'm going to do that in yellow and let's just cut that and paste it behind like so. And then adjust this so I'm going to select them, group them, and then select this all and just center that like so. Okay. Now this is the base artwork with which I'm going to create these wavy shapes. And let's make the brush. So let's go to Window, Brushes, and drag that in here. And we need an art brush, like so, and just say OK. The next thing is we need to build the wavy line. And for that, I'm going to draw a straight line and let's apply a stroke to that. And then let's make waves. So we could also just apply that brush to it and then go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and let's apply zigzag, like so. So we need rounded corners, as you can see. But if we set this to smooth, we don't get the rounded corners that we need. So we need to first set this to corner and maybe slightly less with the size, maybe like this. And then let's go to OK. So the trouble with this is now I'm going to need to round those corners. And for that, I need to expand this. So I need to expand the appearance. And when I expand the appearance, then I'm going to expand the brush as well. So this is nice for judging how this needs to look. But now we first need to get rid of that brush. And then let's go to Object and expand the appearance. And now we can round those corners. And you see, we get slightly different thing. And I think this needs to be slightly higher again, because we are going to round it like so. Okay. Now let's round them like so. And then let's apply that brush again. So like this. Now we need, of course, a copy of this. So let's just go to Reflect, double click it. Make a horizontal axis and a copy like so. So this is nice. And this is our base artwork to build that overlapping brush. And to get that, of course, we need to expand appearance again, because now we need to expand that brush in order to build the overlaps. So. And in order to build the overlaps, we are going to use Live Paint. So let's pick up the color here. I'm pressing the Alt key in order to get that. And then let's create those overlaps. I'm going to just click them. You could also click and drag, but then it's often getting, you know, when it's just some tight corners, then you often paint to the side where you shouldn't paint. So there we are. And that's actually sufficient. We do not need more of a repeat than this, because now we can cut this thing. And in order to cut this thing, we first need to measure how long we need it, and we need to be precise. So we need to find some points that are the same in all these. So let's select it and go to the direct selection tool, and you see there are some points, but we can't use them as orientation because they are in different places. So the points we need to use are these intersections here, and I'm going to take that one as well. So I'm going to drag a rectangle from here to there. And let's just zoom in and get this to that intersection. And I'm going to check it at that place as well. So just to that intersection, like so. So there it is. Okay. Let's make that like this. And also, we are going to expand that Live Paint. So let's go to Object, Live Paint, and no, not Release. So Object, Live Paint, Expand. And then use this all and make a clipping mask. So object clipping mask and make. So this is the repeat we're going to use, and I'm going to undo that. So what we are going to do is, let's just switch this, and I want it like so. So like this, and then let's make the mask. Okay. So the next thing is we need to go to the pathfinders and then use crop to expand the mask, like so. And now we can get rid of the yellow. We do not need the yellow shapes. So let's just select one and go to select same fill color and delete them all. And we could also check if there are invisible objects. So let's just create one invisible object and go to select same fill and stroke. And there actually is one. So let's delete that, because we don't want anything to just get in our way. And then we can select all of this. And you see there are some crossovers there, and it would be nicer to combine them. So let's combine all of this, because if they are separate objects, then they might get distorted so much when applying the brush that we get gaps, and we do not need gaps. So let's fill that with black. And now we can piece this all together. Let's go to Window Brushes. Drag this in here and create the pattern brush. And you see, this is nice. We can set the method to tints in order to be able to apply color to that. And let's go to OK. And then take the ellipse tool, create the circle. Again, Shift and X. And then let's go here, apply that brush. And now we can also apply some color to it, like so. Any color you wish can be applied to that. And there, you've got it. So, nice intertwined lines around the edge of an object. And of course, you can use that with any kind of path and have that along it. That's it. How easy you can create this.